Okay guys, today let us see the installation configuration of the proxy for the Zabbix. Okay, so this is a new server, Linux server, which I have built using AWS. Basically, proxy is one wherein when we are not able to directly reach out to the end servers using the Zabbix server, we'll be using the Zabbix proxy. Zabbix proxy, as the word goes, it's not exactly a server, but it helps in bridging the gap between the servers, which could be in a secure zone or where there are no access given to the ports. Only through this proxy we will be able to communicate to the Zabbix server. So let us see how we're gonna build the proxy and add it to the Zabbix server and start communicating. So I have configured I've written down a few steps. So let's go from the scratch. So this is going to set the permission. That's good. Now let us add a few firewall rules. Okay, it says firewall command not found. So what we will do is we will install the firewall. So it would take a couple of minutes for it to install the firewall. Let it go on. Okay, I would say yes. Go ahead, install it. Okay, that's it. Beautiful. It is completed. Okay. Okay. That's good. So let's go back to configure. The next one, so I'm adding the HTTP and HTTPS into the firewall permanently, basically port 100.0.5.0.5.1, and then I'm gonna reload the firewall command. That's successful. Now let us begin the installation. I've just taken the repo. And that's done. So let's do a clean all, and then let's install it. So we're gonna install using MySQL MariaDB. So as I was saying, for the Zabbix proxy, we need to have a separate server installed, preferably the same OS and same configuration as the Zabbix server. And also this the proxy server should have its own database. It cannot share the database of the Zabbix server. Okay, so that part is done. So we are downloading the bits and start installing it one by one. And here goes the MariaDB installation. So I will have a separate proxy server, its own database connected to another Zabbix server, which is having its own database. So both are standalone in my case. So let's execute this. Secure installation. Enter the current password is usually blank. Okay, set the root password capital Y. Let me put the password. Okay, remove anonymous user, yes, disallow, yes, remove test database, yes, reload, yes. So that's it. So beautiful, that completes. So I've just given the database database password as Zabbix. So let's begin the configuration. So here it's going to log in as root with the password that I've given just now as Zabbix. And then It's going to configure certain things in the database. Likewise, it's going to grant the privileges also. And now, mariadb is off for the proxy. And now it's going to do some zcat command. The username is Zabbix and the password is also Zabbix. We can set anything as the password. I'll kind of make it more complex so that there is no compromise on the password. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to just go and edit this particular file, and here we have to search for DB password and make sure that I have the right password configured. Okay, so it's not there. So insert is equal to Zabbix. So I did not exist. So I'm putting that. So the DB user is Zabbix. Password is also Zabbix. The DB name is Zabbix underscore proxy. This is what we give in the command. Next, config frequency, we're gonna set it as 120. We can set it as 60 also. So basically, that is it. What frequency they should pull. So let me keep it as 120 and then server. Okay. So let me search for the server. Okay, there it goes. So instead of this 127.0.0.1, I am gonna put the IP address of the Zabbix server, right? Because this has to connect to the Zabbix server. Next is the host name. I am gonna give okay, so it's by default given Zabbix proxy, so I'm gonna keep it as Zabbix proxy 02 so that I know. And then the DB name is Zabbix underscore proxy. That's right. Okay, DB user is Zabbix. Okay, DB user is Zabbix. It's good. Now I'm good to save. So we have saved it, and then we're gonna just restart the services. Okay, that's done. Beautiful. And we're gonna enable it. Beautiful, it's created a symbolic link. Now let's go to the Zabbix. What we have to do it here, we'll come to administration, proxies, create proxy. Here we have to give the same name that we gave in the config file. So I'm going to copy that, put it here, keep it as active. Okay. And then add. Okay, so let me show you this, the same thing which I have already done. So just edit the hostname and keep this active. This is the second proxy. So it takes around 2 minutes because we have given the configuration as 120 seconds. So it's going to take at least that much time to start polling. And we're going to see this starts counting. So in the meanwhile, what we will do is we have a Windows server. What I would do is go back here, running instances. I'll just go pick up the Windows box, or rather I'll pick this. This is the IP address that's I'm gonna pick up on the Windows server. Okay, I have already configured to a different proxy, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna search that, and while installing the Zabbix, it should a Zabbix agent on any end server, it should be pointing to the proxy IP. So it should be installed with the pointing to the proxy IP rather than to the Zabbix server. So I made both the changes. I'm gonna close the config. I'm gonna restart the Zabbix agent. Okay, so let's go back to Zabbix. Yeah, now beautiful, it has started communicating. Let's go to configuration, let's go to hosts. Okay, so we're just gonna click on this, and then we're gonna select the Zabbix proxy server to update. Okay, so let's wait for a while it goes and communicates with the second proxy. So this almost, yeah, this marks the completion of the installation configuration of the proxy in Zabbix and monitoring of the devices. So what can be done is, suppose we are having a few devices which we have to start pointing to the second proxy, then we can select all of them or a multi-select basically, and then click on mass update. Click on mass update, and then click on the monitored proxy, select the second proxy and click on update. So with that, or if you want to select a group and then do that, that is also fine. By this, all the hosts will start pointing towards the second proxy, and that works well for us. So if you just go here and start apply, we can see that it is working fine. That's it. More videos in the next. Thank you.